Hey everybody, welcome back to Tanner's Books and Beyond. So my original plan for today was to do a review of Eve and Adam, but unfortunately I slept in, like, until noon, which almost never happens. I have no idea why I was so tired, but I guess I was. And so I really didn't think I would have enough time to record it because I have a lot of stuff I want to say. So I just started looking through popular book tags, trying to find one that I thought would be simple and I'd be able to get through quickly, and I found this one. It's the BookTube color tag. And I guess when this tag first started out, everyone chose the color of books that they wanted to talk about, but then over time it shifted into the people tagging you also get to choose that color. But then again, I'm also tagging myself, I guess. I'm not being picked by anybody else, so I guess I do get to choose my own color after all. So that's step one, and I'm gonna choose orange. Step two is to simply show all the books that I have in that color. So we have Night Child by Jess Battis, which I spoke about earlier briefly. Then there's Stephen King's The Drawing of the Three, which is the second book in the Dark Tower series. I think most people might consider this red, but to me it looks more orange. It's at least a blood orange. Also by Stephen King, we've got Needful Things, which again has a significant amount of blue on it, but I feel like the majority of it shows up orange, so I'm including it. Then we've got Hunger and Plague, which are both part of the Gone series by Michael Grant. Hunger is the second book and Plague is the fourth book. Then there's The Fireman by Joe Hill, which as you can see, I got at a sweet discount. And then To the Nines, which is a Stephanie Plum book by Janet Ivanovich. Now the third step is to separate them into a read and unread pile, but I didn't realize that when I first picking out, but the only books I haven't read are these two, just The Fireman and To the Nines. So I know, I guess I just really like prioritizing my orange books. So step number four is what book do I want to read the most? And admittedly, I don't have very many options to choose out of these two. Plus, it's kind of a tie between the two. I mean, with The Fireman, it's by Joe Hill, and he's Stephen King's son, and he definitely lives up to his legacy. He's an exquisite author, and I've already read Horns, and I read Nosferatu 2, and they were both really great, really gritty horror novels, and so this is probably going to be just as good, and I'm really excited. But on the other hand, we've got To the Nines by Janet Ivanovich, and it's a Stephanie Plum novel, and I loved the Stephanie Plum book since I was in, like, middle school, and I keep on starting this and then stopping it because I just get busy or whatever, and so I feel like I owe it to this book to read it as soon as I can, so I'm really torn between these two books. Step number five is to pick my favorite book of the ones that I've read, and I'm gonna go with Needful Things by Stephen King, which is quite possibly my favorite book of all time, if not my favorite Stephen King book. It is just so terrifying and so disturbing because the plot of it is that a mysterious little shop opens up in a small town, and everyone who goes in there, they find this one thing that they just absolutely have to have, and it's just out of their price range. But then the owner is like, well, I could give it to you for a discount if you do me a little favor. And these favors start off as seemingly harmless pranks, but slowly they escalate into things like killing people or threatening them or taking them hostage or convincing people that their loved ones are having affairs. And so slowly the entire town kind of turns on each other. The drama and the terror just really, really builds into a really epic finale. And of course, as a Stephen King book, it also has a lot of really good character work because that's what he does. He starts with a bunch of interesting characters and just slowly develops them and sees how things go. And so that's why one of the reasons I love Stephen King so much is because so much of the character development in his books seems natural, and this is where it shines the best in my opinion. So step number six is to pick my favorite cover out of all of them, and admittedly, a lot of my orange books have fairly lackluster covers, but the one that stands out the most to me is The Fireman by Joe Hill. It's probably just because fire always makes things look intense, and this seems to be a very intense and very suspenseful book. I just really like that image at the bottom of this lone figure standing in the middle of an inferno, and it's like, are they a bad guy who's coming surrounded with fire and you should be afraid of them, or are they a good person who's standing amongst the flames and they're able to survive throughout whatever wits or skills that they have? So I feel it really works, and if it weren't for the fact that I love the author and it had a sweet discount, that the cover would probably be one of the things that drew me in as well. So then number seven is to pick the least favorite cover, and like I just said, a lot of them are fairly lackluster, and I feel like the worst offender is To the Nines by Janet Ivanovich. I'm sure it's gonna be hilarious like all the other Stephanie Plum books, but it's literally just Janet Ivanovich, To the Nines. That's it. It does match up with the style of all the other Stephanie Plum books, so it probably looks better when it's with the rest of them, but just by itself, it's super bland, and if you weren't already a fan of the Stephanie Plum series, then you probably wouldn't bother getting it at all. Now, step number eight is to find a book of this color that you want to purchase, but I went through my entire books to get list, and I didn't find a single book that had an orange cover. So maybe I just need to dig deeper and find different editions, or maybe I just have to go to the bookstore and start looking specifically for orange books. But I don't know, I guess I've exhausted my orange quota for the past few years. Then step number 9 is to find something on your bookshelf or around you that's of this color, and I don't even know if I have anything orange in my room. Oh, here we go. Speaker. It's a speaker, and it's waterproof, and it's got a suction cup on it, so you can actually listen to your iPod and your music with Bluetooth capabilities while you're in your shower, so you don't have to worry about bringing your phone in and then getting it water damaged. And of course, number 10 is to tag people. And fun news, I just subscribed to a bunch of cool booktubers, so I'm going to be tagging some people that I just recently started watching their videos, because I like them, and I think that they'll have fun things to say for this tag, even though I might be overreaching because I'm just a small child and these guys have subscribers in the thousands. But yeah, so I'm going to tag Chapter Select, I'm going to tag Insane Reader, and I'm going to tag the 8th Potter. So I don't know, if you guys have time and you want to do the color book tag, you can do the color book tag. But that's all I've got for you guys today. Stay tuned, because soon I should be having my Even Adam review/rant out. But until next time, I'll see you all later.